All right. So where were we? We were trying to do this merge sort. So let us complete this. Okay.
So from yesterday's part, I hope nothing is
unclear. Okay. So I'll just move ahead with merge sort. Okay. Array A1 to AN and output should be a sorted list from A1 to AN. Okay. So सॉर्टेड लिस्ट का मतलब क्या है? कल्पेश मर्से सॉर्टेड लिस्ट का मतलब क्या है? कल्पेश
सर,
मैं कल्पेश से पूछ रहा हूँ
सर, मुझे एक डाउट था।
हाँ रुक जा, हाँ बोलो।
सर मतलब जब हम सॉर्ट कर रहे हैं तो ऐसे कोई भी ब्लॉक उठा के फिर कंपेयर कर रहे हैं, मतलब लीनियरली कंपेयर कर रहे हैं क्या?
हाँ कर रहे थे ना कल।
तो मतलब ऐसे कोई भी ब्लॉक उठा के करना है ना, ऐसे स्पेसिफिक नहीं है ना कि यही ब्लॉक उठा के हमें करना है करके।
डिपेंड करता है ना कि तुम बड़े ब्लॉक को जो छोटे दो पार्ट में डिवाइड किए हो उस उन दोनों को करना होता है। मैंने ये अलग अलग कलर में क्यों बनाया है?
नहीं नहीं, जैसे कि इधर 52 और 64 लिया हमने,
इन दोनों को कंपेयर करेंगे ना, इन दोनों को नहीं करेंगे। समझ में आ रहा है?
हाँ, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड है 52 64, तो हमने फिर नीचे क्या लिखा था, 0 एंड 18, फिर 0 को पहले कंपेयर किया था 52 से।
हाँ।
तो ऐसे हम कोई भी ब्लॉक ले सकते हैं, मतलब इन दोनों ब्लॉक में से हम किसी को भी सेलेक्ट कर सकते हैं, ऐसा ना?
नहीं ना, ये जैसे दिख रहा है वैसे ही लिखना है ना, मतलब क्या कंफ्यूजन है? जैसे दिख रहा है वैसे लिखना है, इसमें क्या कंफ्यूजन है?
ओके ओके ठीक है सर, मतलब जैसा वो ऑलरेडी हमें दिख रहा है हमें उसी हिसाब से उसको लिखना है।
उसके पहले स्टेप में जहां पहुंचा है वहां बस, उसके पहले वाले स्टेप में जैसे दिखता है वैसे। दैट इज हाउ योर एल्गोरिथम वर्क्स, राइट? स्टेप बाय स्टेप।
ओके
सर, प्रीवियस स्टेप व्हाटएवर इज कंप्लीट यू टेक दैट, डू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप। ओके
ओके सर।
राइट, सो हु इज वन? सो दीपक, सॉर्टेड लिस्ट का मतलब क्या है? दीपक राजभर,
arrange in order ascending or descending.
Okay, thank you. So we will stick with ascending order, okay, just as convention. All right, so this is your first first example of writing what is called a pseudo code. Pseudo code, this is a way of writing an algorithm. So that there is no mistake. Okay, so you have to be careful when you write the algorithm. Sir, okay. So let me. Okay. Yeah, that's okay. So how will you write a pseudo? So pseudo code involves first line of a pseudo code. So once. So this is like writing function descriptions. Some of you who have then little bit of C++ or something might be familiar. Others, just pay attention. Okay. So first you have to give a name to the algorithm. So the name of the algorithm right now is merge sort. That's the name. Bracket. What all are the inputs? Kalyani, what are the inputs of this algorithm? Kalyani Patel.
They can be arranged in alphabetical order or something.
That is fine, but I'm just asking what are the inputs. Input kya diya hai hamein? Input ka matlab samajh mein aa raha hai? Whatever is given to us. Output is the final answer. So what is the input?
वन टू एन
और
ऑफ इंटीजर्स अरे ऑफ फ्रॉम वन टू एन इंटीजर.
हाँ यहाँ जो लिखा है वही है बट इट्स नॉट वन टू एन एन अरे ए वन टू ए एन. ओके दैट्स ऑल इट मींस.
ओके या
सो वी विल राइट दिस एज ए वन टू एन. This is what it looks like. Okay, this is how you start. Then what will you do? You draw a bracket just to make sure that this is open. Okay, and then finally there will be a close bracket. Everything inside this is the algorithm. Okay, so we have opened the bracket. Right. So now, what is the first step? What do we do when we get an array of length n? What is the first thing we do? So, Sangvi, what is the first thing we should do? पहले के examples में हैं हम क्या करते थे एक array मिलने के बाद
हम उसको डिवाइड करते थे.
या डिवाइड इनटू बट व्हाट कहाँ पे डिवाइड करना था
सेम पार्ट्स में
कहाँ पे
सेम पार्ट्स
रिपीट करो सुनाई नहीं दिया
सेम पार्ट्स में
same parts. अच्छा अच्छा ओके यू आर डिवाइडिंग देम इनटू टू इक्वल पार्ट्स. ओके सो इनटू हाफ हाफ. ओके फाइन. और उसके बाद क्या होगा यू विल अप्लाई द सेम एल्गोरिथम सो यू विल गेट एन आंसर राइट यू विल गेट एन आंसर देयर. ओके सो वी नीड टू टेक दैट आंसर दैट इज अ सॉर्टेड पार्ट राइट. सो नाउ वी विल से ए वन सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डिक्लेयरिंग Let me say, this is the meaning of a new variable being assigned something. Okay, so A1 is assigned the value of merge sort A, the first half. First half मतलब कहाँ तक जाएगा शिव प्रसाद? शिव प्रसाद कहाँ तक जाएगा ये
सर? सर इट विल गो टू अप टू एन माइट बी
यू हैव टू डिवाइड इट इनटू टू हाफ्स नो टू पार्ट्स ऑफ हाफ लेंथ. पहले लेंथ एन था अभी कहाँ तक जाएगा
सर? एन बाय टू.
ओके थैंक यू. सो दिस गोज़ टू एन बाय टू. ओके एंड देन सो दिस इज फाइन एंड देन ए टू इज द सेकेंड हाफ. सो यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हेन आई से मर्ज सॉर्ट ऑफ दिस इज अज्यूम दैट ए वन एंड ए टू विल बी सॉर्टेड फाइनली. ओके सो ए टू इज दिस हू विल टेल मी फ्रॉम वेयर टू वेयर Sai?
From n by 2 to n.
Right. So, let us be a little more specific so that we don't miss anything. So, let's go up to floor n by 2 and then here we'll go floor n by 2 plus 1 to n. Is that okay? So that there is no overlap and we don't miss anything. So, we will be a little more careful. Okay, right. So after this, what about A1 and A2? A1 and A2, do we have to sort them now? Again, Rashmi, A1 and A2 ko sort karne hai kya individually? Rashmi?
यस सर।
ए वन और ए टू को सॉर्ट करना है क्या?
यस सर, कैन यू जस्ट रिपीट?
या सो शुड वी सॉर्ट ए वन एंड ए टू अगेन? व्हाट डू वी नो अबाउट ए वन एंड ए टू?
Yes, so it's 1, then L by L by 2.
क्या कह रही हो रश्मि? मैंने क्या सवाल पूछा था, तुम क्या जवाब दे रही हो? आर यू पेइंग अटेंशन? संकेत भाग ए वन एंड ए टू आर इंडिविजुअली सॉर्टेड और नॉट? संकेत बता सकते हो? कौन बताएगा मुझे ए वन ए टू आर सॉर्टेड और नॉट? अपर्णा, ए वन और ए टू का क्रम में क्या पता है? अपर्णा करना यहाँ हो या नहीं हो?
हेलो सर।
हाँ
सर, मैं भी प्लान
बोला
क्या कह रहे हैं?
क्या क्या
ट्रैवलिंग में इसलिए मैं।
अच्छा ठीक है, तो कम से कम लेक्चर सुनाई दे रहा है आपको कि क्या चल रहा है?
हाँ सर।
ओके थैंक्स। अच्छा ठीक है सो हु एल्स वांट्स टू गिव मी एन आंसर? अरे मैं अभी एक्चुअली इसका आंसर बोला हूँ दो तीन सेंटेंस पहले। व्हाट डू वी नो अबाउट ए वन एंड ए टू
सर?
हाँ
सर, ए वन को फिर डिवाइड करेंगे मतलब हाफ एंड देन सॉर्टिंग।
हाँ क्यों करेंगे? ए वन के बारे में क्या पता है हमको? ए वन को डिवाइड करेंगे ठीक है, वो अलग लेवल पे है, वो यहाँ पे हो गया है जब यहाँ मर्ज सॉर्ट ए वन टू एन बाई टू लिख दिया, तो इसके अंदर ए वन डिवाइड होगा हाफ में। मैं ये पूछ रहा हूँ कि अगर ये स्टेप पूरा हो गया तो ए वन के बारे में हमको क्या पता है? व्हेन दिस स्टेप कंप्लीट्स व्हाट डू वी नो अबाउट ए वन?
ए वन ए टू सॉर्टेड है।
A1 and A2 are both sorted. Is that okay?
Sir, नहीं समझे। Sorted कैसे? अभी तो हमने divide किया ना इसको।
हाँ, so this is what is called a recursive algorithm. Sudo code में, now pay attention. Merge sort is supposed to give you output as the sorted list. Right now you divide and then the smaller parts you have to sort that, right? In order to do that you again divide, but then that is the same algorithm applied to the smaller part. So now this, when you open it up, it will have these parts and then again it will be some a1 prime merge sort aise hoga a2 prime इसके अंदर। बट दैट इज नॉट माई पॉइंट। इफ यू राइट दिस मच एंड इफ दिस स्टेप इज ओवर, इट मीन्स दिस हैज बीन सॉर्टेड, दिस एल्गोरिथम इज कंप्लीट ऑन दिस इनपुट, विच मीन्स ए वन इज सॉर्टेड। And now we have to put them together. So we will assume that A1 is sorted and then we will put them together. Ravi, clear hai kya? Ravi?
Sir, repeat karna hai kya?
कौन था ये, इसको रिपीट चाहिए, किसको रिपीट चाहिए? अरे मैंने नाम नहीं लिखा यार, अरे किसको रिपीट चाहिए? मैं तुम्हें चलूंगा आगे, बताओ किसको रिपीट चाहिए? आप लोग कहाँ हो यार? आप लोग, आपका ऑडियो एक तो सुनाई नहीं देता या आप कनेक्टेड हो कि नहीं दिख नहीं रहा मुझे. What is going on? So,
समझा सर.
अच्छा, प्रिया को समझ गया. रवि, आर यू हियर? आर यू हियर? So this is what it is, and now we have to, what do we have to do? We have to combine this, remember? So we have to combine two lists of size n by 2 and get two sorted lists of size n by 2 and get a list of size and get a sorted list of size n, right? So that is something that remains to be done, but now that we will write down separately, okay? So this is one important thing when you write programs or pseudo codes or algorithms or whatever, which is that you divide your work into smaller blocks. Okay. And it becomes easier to follow and understand. Okay. So what we will do now is the final answer is just The final answer is just, let me give it another name, merge A1, A2. Okay. It will merge A1 and A2, which are already sorted, and it will give me the sorted answer. And then when I put a bracket like this, now pay attention, what happens? If you give an input A1 to AN, that goes inside, it gets broken down into A1 to AN by 2. An by 2 plus 1 to an. For each of these, merge sort will apply. So at the lower level, merge sort will sort this, give me A1. At the lower level, merge sort will sort the second block, give me A2. So A1 and A2 are the sorted first and second halves of A1 to n. So assuming that A1 and A2 are sorted, what remains to be done? We have to combine these two to get a sorted version of A2. Which is what we do here, merge of A1, A2. And then whatever is the answer, that gets declared here itself. So we put this bracket. So this program ends here. So now, what work is remaining to be done? Who wants to try? Bhagyashree? Kaam ho gaya kya ya kuch aur kaam baki hai?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, you don't know? So are you not following what is going on?
I'm following, but what would be remaining after merge?
Right, so we have not written merge, no? Have we written what merge is? Tell me, have we written what merge is? Do you understand that we have not written what merge is doing? Neelam, is it clear that we have not yet written what merge is doing? Neelam?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear that we have not written what merge is doing? Kya baki hai abhi yahan pe?
Sir. सॉर्टेड हो गया ना अभी?
सॉर्टेड हो गया, लेकिन हर स्टेप लिख के हो गया है क्या, या कुछ बाकी है? ओके पल्लवी, कोई स्टेप बाकी है यहाँ लिखने में?
यस सर।
हाँ बताओ क्या लिखना बाकी है
सर? सर मर्ज को डिफाइन नहीं किया ना।
हाँ फाइन, सो वी हैव नॉट रिटन डाउन स्टेप्स फॉर डूइंग दिस। ऐसे नाम देके लिख दिया लेकिन उसका स्टेप्स नहीं लिखा है, सो दैट इज व्हाट इज रिमेनिंग। सो दैट्स व्हाट वी विल डू नाउ नेक्स्ट। ओके सो नाउ लेट अस सिंपली राइट अ जनरल एल्गोरिथम फॉर व्हाट मर्ज इज सपोज्ड टू बी और सपोज्ड टू बी। सो नाउ मर्ज, और वन सेकंड, आई थिंक आई डिड नॉट राइट, ओके ब्रैकेट आई रिटन दैट। सो मर्ज, what are the two inputs? Let's give some two inputs, a 1 to n and b 1 to n. Do you understand this n and that n are not related, because now when you call this function merge, you are putting a1 and a2 in place of a and b here, okay, and then whatever we write here that will be performed. Okay, so now we have to write this. Alright, so suppose now you are given two arrays A1 and A2, A and B, both of length n. This is A and this is B. Both are sorted. A and B are both sorted. That is something we already know. Now we have to combine these to get a sorted array. So what is the first thing that we will do? What is the first step? Salma, what is the first step?
Sir, A और B के values हम लोग compare करेंगे ना?
A और B का value, A और B तो बहुत ही बड़ा list है, कौन सा value compare करेंगे A और B में से?
Sir, हम लोग यहाँ 1 to n दिया हुआ है, तो हम लोग सर 1 टू 10 ले।
1 टू 10, अरे व्हाट डिड वी डू लास्ट टाइम, ये कुछ याद है ये जो किया था पिछली बार कल के क्लास में? हर्षदा,
यस सर।
हर्षदा,
यस।
सो व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप, कैन डू यू रिमेंबर?
नो सर।
नो, ओके फाइन। Who else wants to try? Somebody wants to try? Ashar Gavte?
Correct.
I hope I'm pronouncing right. Ashar Gavte, do you want to try? Nobody?
Sir.
Priya, tum ruk jao. Okay. Kam se kam mera attendance hone tak ruk jao. मधुरा, मधुरा डू यू वांट टू ट्राई? Pratiksha, do you want to try?
Sir, हम पहले A को sort करने के steps लिखेंगे।
A को sort करने के, A sorted है Pratiksha। A and B are now sorted. You are given two, these two are two halves of a bigger list. Now, okay? Now you want to form the bigger list from the two. So what is the first comparison you will make?
A और B को कंपेयर करेंगे।
A और B एरे है, A और B लिस्ट का नाम है, कौन से वैल्यूज को कंपेयर करेंगे प्रतीक्षा? डू यू अंडरस्टैंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन लिस्ट एंड जस्ट अ सिंगल नंबर? So I'm not going ahead without somebody telling me this. So this is very, very basic. We have done this so many times. We did this two times yesterday.
Sir?
Yes, what is
this? Sir, Kalyani. Sir, we will compare the first place of both the arrays. First number
first
of
number.
Both
so
the arrays.
A of 1 and B of 1, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And then?
And then whichever is small, we will take it first.
Okay. So we have to build a list. So let's start with an empty list, C equal to empty. So C assigned to be empty. Okay. And now what we say is C of 1 is equal to minimum of A of 1, B of 1. And then what do we do? They want to
whichever is minimum, we will take it equal to C1, na?
That's what we have done, yes. What is the next step?
Whichever is small, we will clear it out. And again, we will compare to another one.
That's correct. But you need to know which is small, no?
Yes.
So how will we understand that?
सर
यस
सर लेकिन हम लोग अभी से ही कंपेयर कैसे कर सकते हैं लास्ट प्रॉब्लम में हमने पहले टू हाफ्स में डिवाइड किया फिर उसको फिर डिवाइड किया था ना
टेन कह रहा था कि हमारे नाउ ए एंड बी आर द टू हाफ्स ऑफ अ बिगर एरे
हां पर फिर से हमें डिवाइड करना पड़ेगा ना जब तक सिर्फ दो नंबर्स नहीं बच जाते हैं
A or B already sorted है ना? A or B are already sorted. Do you remember what we did when we got two pieces which were already sorted? यहाँ पे did we divide these two further? We did not divide these two further.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is what we will do now. Let me know. So what we will do is what is called a while loop. Okay, so let us set let us say two numbers p equal to p assigned to 1 and q assigned to 1. Okay, p and q will run through the index of k and b. Okay, and what is the length up to n? So now what we do is while p is less than n, or q is less than n, while one of these two is true, so okay, one second, I also have to say p q r, r is also set to 1. So while p less than n or q less than n, whatever is the value of r at that point of time, I'll assign c of r to b the minimum amount of a of p and b of q. Okay, so let me write this down and then I'll explain. Okay, right, but now the problem is we don't know which one is smaller, therefore instead of doing minimum we should compare, right? Without comparing, this is not a good idea. Okay, so while can you check? So I am leaving a space here in order to write the next step. Okay, so comparison, if a of p is less than b of q, then c of r will be assigned a of p, because I want to assign the minimum, right? But now a of p is the minimum and whatever is assigned as the new value, that is removed, right? So removing a of p means I'll move the pointer p to p plus 1. Okay, so a of p is forgotten. Now I am at a of p plus 1. That is the meaning of forgetting. And then I'll write n div. Oh, sorry, not n div. We are not done. But if this is not true, then we have else, which means a of p is greater than b of q. In that case, c of r will be assigned b of q, and pointer of q will change. Q changes to q plus 1. And this is the end. Okay, are we done now? Not again, because R is a problem. So after doing both of these, we have to go to the next place in C. So we have to go R. So I need some space. So now we have to do R is assigned R plus 1. Go to the new place. Okay, we keep doing this until this condition is over. So we end up. Alright. So let me explain what it is that we are doing. This is exactly what we are doing in solving. Okay. So the first step is we compare a1 with b1. Okay. So I have said p equal to 1, q equal to 1, r equal to 1. And there is a longer array c which I have to fill. Okay. So currently p is here. currently P is here, Q is here, and R is here. डायग्राम अच्छा नहीं है ना, क्योंकि ड्रॉ है. सो इसके So currently P is here, Q is here, R is here. These are variables, these are pointers which have the address, which have the location. So for C here, I compare AP with BQ. Both are one. Right. Compare AP with BQ, but I don't only need the minimum value, I also need to know which one is minimum. So I cannot simply write minimum of AP BQ. I need to know which one. Therefore, I write it down in more detail. So, how long should we go until we are at the end? No? So that is why we have while P less than N or Q less than N. One of them should be less than N. Then we can continue. Is that okay? Or let's say both are less than N. So both are less than N. Even that is okay. While P less than N and Q less than N. So immediately we will compare current value of A and current value of B and put it into current place of C. So AP with BQ. If AP is less than BQ, then this value takes A of P. And then we forget this box and we go to P plus 1, right? So the new value of P is the next value. That is the meaning of this step. Okay. If that did not happen, if BQ was less than AP, then CR will be BQ and Q will move one location to the right. So this becomes Q, we drop this, this becomes the new value of Q. That is this step. Okay, that is the meaning of this. Okay, and we keep going like this. So in the algorithm, you only need to say how to do one such step and it will keep repeating, right? So this is the logic. We have completely described what to do. What else is remaining? Once you fill C, you should now fill the next element in the next entry. So you have to move R to R plus 1. That is this step. And then again, you will continue comparing. Okay, so that is the idea. I mean, it is exactly what we were talking about, and this is the abstract thing. Okay, so now what I wanted to do is, so this part anyways got recorded. Listen to this again. The previous example which we worked out, go there, listen to that recording again. Okay, so listen to both of these recordings 2-3 times and you will, it will be clear what we are doing, if it is not clear now. Okay, so listen to both. And we keep doing this until any of these is true. So until we can keep moving to the right. End one. So when will this end? When either P is equal to N or Q is equal to N. When one of them is equal to N, there is nothing to go forward. Right? So we will stop there and then we have to handle that part separately. So how do we handle that part? Okay, so let me insert a new slide.
सर एरो क्या डिनोट कर रहे हैं कि हम उसमें वो इनपुट दे रहे हैं उसको
असाइनिंग दैट वैल्यू हां दैट वैल्यू इज असाइंड टू द थिंग ऑन द लेफ्ट तो एल्गोरिथम का नोटेशन दैट्स व्हाई आई वाज सेइंग नो पी इज असाइंड 1 और पी इज इक्वल टू 1 वैल्यू 1 इज पुट इन इन द वेरिएबल पी ओके सो नाउ दिस इज वेयर सो वी आर हियर दिस So once this is done, what remains to check is the end case when P is equal to N or Q is equal to N. Okay, so now if P So whether the value is equal to n or not, that is used sort of written down by this notation. Because we are not assigning the value, we are only checking what value is already there. When we say p equal to n, it might think that we are assigning the value n to p. That's not what we are doing. We are only checking whatever value is already there. Right? If p is equal to n, what do we do?
We'll write it as it is.
No, right? We still have to check a of n with the entry below. We still have to check it with the entry below. Okay, so here's the thing. We still have to check if a of p is less than b of q. We don't know where q is, so we still have to check. Okay, if a p less than b q, then again CR will be assigned A of P. But now what? AP is over. Now there is nothing more. You see? So CR is assigned AP. But then CR plus 1 is assigned the remaining entries. Because AP plus 1 is not there at all. Okay. So let me just write it in short and say this. Then we are simply assigning CR to the remaining up to 2n to be just the values. Okay. CR will get the value AP. And CR plus 1 to 2n will get the remaining values dq to n. Right? Because now there is nothing more to compare. Right? The array A has been used completely. So from bq onwards, whatever values are there, they will just come at the end. And if this is not true, then the reverse. So else, what we do is the reverse of this. So C of R will be given B of Q. Right? But then you cannot put AP there itself. Now you can only say Q changes to Q plus 1. Okay. Similarly for q, so I want you to write this down. If q equal to n, then there is a part here. Okay, I want you to write it down here, and that will complete the algorithm. Okay, that will be the end of the algorithm here. Similarly, just check this and write this down. Okay, so I will just stop here since we have a bit of time. So this is already a little bit of a load for you guys to understand. Okay, so I'm not going to teach more today. What I want you to do is listen to this recording, look at the previous recordings, look at the examples that we worked out. Okay. Try to complete this code. Okay. Complete this code on your own. Is that fine? So, in fact, take your time. So, let's not meet in the afternoon. Okay. Today we are not meeting in the afternoon. I had said we will have tutorial, but let's not have tutorial because this you have to complete first. Okay. So, this do it on your own. Take as much time as you want. We have today, tomorrow. Take as much time as you want, complete this on your own, and then we'll meet on Monday morning. Is that from Monday morning? I'll start with the tutorial and the next part, the next kind of sorting. Okay, this is over. This part is easy. I want you to complete this part. Okay then. So thank you. See you on Monday.
Thank you, sir.
I'll put the links.
Thanks, sir.
I'll put the
link. Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Uh-huh, yeah.